DR is a 2016 Hall of Fame inductee in the Lineman's Hall of Fame. And Mr. Graves, can you tell us what it means to you to be inducted into the Lineman Hall of Fame?
Sir, I'm still overwhelmed. I mean, I never thought anything like this would ever anybody was even watching me. I really cared, you know. And this, I've gained a lot of respect for everybody. If you guys put this thing on, I'm talking about that. Y'all do a lot of work, you have to, you know. But you won't know about me, don't you? Yeah, I started the line of work when I was actually 17 years old. And that was with a telephone outfit. That telephone lineman was used a lot then because it stayed in overhead. But it started going underground, and you couldn't find a job as a lineman in a telephone where they didn't need nobody. They needed labor, you know. Nothing big as somebody's shovel and stuff like that. Me and this friend of mine, we got to thinking about a thing, and it was a distribution outfit called Richard Associates. They were working out of Baxley, Georgia, which is 20 miles from us. And we went over, and this superintendent, he scared me to death to start with. He was older, I say older, he was, you know, some older, good deal, I reckon. But anyway, he looked at me and he said, yeah, we're going to reach Malama, not him, but South Carolina. He said, are y'all scared of heights? And we said, no, we thought we could find a pole and a little telephone book. Yeah, but I can jump back. But anyway, we told him, you know, we weren't afraid to fly up high. He said, they was a tall pole, though. He had said he was strong. But they were 65, 70s, 80s, and that area, maybe a few 90s. And we started work that day. In the first pole, they put us with two German linemen, one on each side, and we were their apprentices, you know. But we were airframe and H-frame structures, and you know what that can entail. Cross arm on and together. And I looked over my buddy, he was just getting that, had to get loose from the pole and get on that cross arm. And leaned over to hook those bells as they were coming up, and they went and brought them up. And I looked at that thing and looked at the ground and looked at him. I said, I'll tell you one thing, if I make it today, I'll be in home tonight. Well, I didn't make it home that night, and I made it, and thank goodness I got a lot of experience from that gentleman that was running that outfit. And as the years went by, home and family, you know, means a lot. Me and my wife was married 54 years, 2 weeks after I got elected. And there was, she was 18 by then, and I was 22. And you can imagine what it was right out of the land. I might not have made it, but anyway, it went in my hand, come up and flew up, that's probably me. But anyway, and these apparatuses you see me use, I've just started using them in the last few years.
And you went on work 30 years after that?
Yes, sir, about 34 really, but...
34 years?
Yeah, you know, after that.
Well, and thank you for your contribution to this industry. We appreciate all you've done.
Sure, thank you, sir.
Thank you.